بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وحبيب إله العالمين أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد، اللهم صل على محمد وآل محمد، وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين الهداة المهديين، واللعنة الدائمة على أعدائهم أجمعين إلى قيام يوم الدين. Respected brothers and sisters, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The 15th of Ramadan witnessed a new dawn of blessings for Ahlul Bayt alayhimus salam. And that was through the glorious birthday of Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam. Imam al-Hasan, the second Imam of Ahlul Bayt. Imam al-Hasan was the first grandson of Rasulullah, and that's why a new dawn started for Ahlul Bayt, the first grandson for Rasulullah, the first son for Imam Ali alayhi salam. So the promise of Allah, the gift of Allah to the Holy Prophet Al-Kawthar, the abundance of good that he would have an offspring, had finally come to fruit through his grandson Al-Imam Al-Hasan Al-Mushtaba alayhi salam, and his lineage would continue through Al-Imam Al-Hasan. Now, as we know, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi had three sons of his own that died at a young age. He had Abdullah and Qasim and Ibrahim. All of these sons of the Prophet who died while they were young. And that left a scar in the Prophet's heart. The fact that he lost his own sons. And he always yearned for sons. He always wanted to have sons. Until finally, he had Al-Imam Al-Hasan alayhi salam. And even though Al-Imam al-Hasan was technically and biologically the grandson of the Prophet, but he considered him as his own son. He considered him as a son, and he used to call him Ibni, my son. In a tradition, the Prophet tells Imam Ali that every messenger of God, their lineage continues through their sons except me, Rasulullah. My lineage continues through my daughter Fatima and through my grandsons Hassan and Hussein. So the Prophet considered Imam Hassan as his own son, not his grandson. And in fact, there is a hadith that is narrated by Sunni books. It is narrated by the book of At-Tabarani, one of the ulama, Sunni ulama, by the name of At-Tabarani. He narrates a hadith from Umar ibn al-Khattab, where Umar says, I heard Rasulullah say, إن كل بني أنثى فعصبتهم لأبيهم. He says that every child, this is a general law, every child, their lineage will be through their father, not through their mother. They will be attributed to their father, not their mother. ما خلا ولدي فاطمة فأنا عصبتهم وأنا أبوهم. Every child will take the lineage of their father and their paternal grandfather, not their mother or their maternal grandfather. Every child, except, he says, the sons of Fatima. Hassan and Hussein, أَنَا عُصْبَتُهُمْ وَأَنَا أَبُهُمْ. I am their father. They will take my lineage. So Imam Hassan عليه السلام was the son of Rasulullah. Even though biologically he was his grandson, but the Prophet says, Imam Hassan and Hussein are my sons. They will take after me. And in the Battle of Jamal, Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam gave a spear to his son Muhammad ibn al-Hanafiyya, who was not the daughter of Fatima. Muhammad ibn al-Hanafiyya was not the daughter of Fatima, but he was the son of Imam Ali. He gave him a spear and he told him to go and kill that camel that was causing the fitna in Jamal, in the Battle of Jamal. Muhammad ibn al-Hanafiyya took the spear. He went, but he could not accomplish that mission. He came back disappointed. Imam Hassan alayhi salam took the spear from his brother Muhammad ibn al-Hanafiyya, and now he went. A couple of minutes later, Imam Hassan alayhi salam comes holding the spear with blood on it. He tells his father, my dear father, Amir al-Mu'mineen, I have killed the camel. So Muhammad ibn al-Hanafiyya, he felt disappointed, upset, that he was not able to accomplish that objective, but Imam Hassan alayhi salam was able to do that. Amir al-Mu'mineen looked at his son Muhammad ibn al-Hanafiyya and he told him, لا تأنف يا بني. Do not feel sad. Do not feel upset. فَإِنَّهُ ابْنُ النَّبِي وَأَنْتَ ابْنُ عَلِيٍّ. He told him, even though he is your brother, but there is a big difference between you and Hassan. What's the difference? Hassan is the son of the Nabi, the Prophet, while you are the son of Ali. Of course, the son of the Prophet is going to be greater than the son of Amir al-Mu'mineen. Even though they are brothers, even though they are both the sons of Amir al-Mu'mineen, but Imam Hassan is in addition the son of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. So of course he will excel. Of course he will be better than you. So do not feel disappointed. When Imam Hassan alayhi salam was born, the Holy Prophet went to the house of Fatima alayhi salam, and he was so happy and excited. He asked to see Al-Imam Al-Hassan. Fatima gave her father Rasulullah that baby. The Holy Prophet, when he saw Imam Hassan alayhi salam, he did the adhan in his right ear and the iqama in his left ear, and it became a sunnah that every child, when they are born, the adhan and iqama are done in their ears. And then he asked Fatima, he asked, where is Imam Ali? Imam Ali alayhi salam came. Ya Ali, what did you name this child? Look at the respect Imam Ali had to Rasulullah. Ma kuntu li asbiqaka ya Rasulullah. I'm waiting for you. I will leave that honor for you. You give him a name, ya Rasulullah. Rasulullah says, wa ma kuntu li asbiqa rabbi fi dhalik. He says, in me, I will wait Allah azza wa jal to designate a name for Imam Hassan. And then Jibra'il alayhi salam comes down, and he tells the Holy Prophet, Ya Rasulullah, Allah sends a salam to you. And he tells you that Ali to you is like Harun to Musa. Harun, the successor of Musa, and Ali is your successor. And thus Allah tells you to name him after the son of Harun. What's the son of Harun's name? He tells him his name is Shubbar. In Arabic, it would be Hassan. So this is where Rasulullah said, we will name him Hassan. So you see how great Al-Imam Al-Hassan is. Not only is he chosen by God to lead the world, but he is also, his name is chosen by Allah Azza wa Jal. So these Imams of Ahlul Bayt, they were chosen by God to be Imams, and even their names, they were chosen by Allah Azza wa Jal, which shows how important and close they are to the Almighty Allah. After that, the Holy Prophet did a aqiqah. Aqiqah is when you have a child born, you slaughter an animal like a sheep, and you distribute the meat to anyone that is in need, or you give it to anyone. They don't even necessarily have to be someone that is needy. And it became a sunnah that on the seventh day when a child is born, that you do the aqiqah. And the ahadith tell us it is highly recommended to do the aqiqah when you have a child. Ask someone either here in the Middle East to buy a sheep, slaughter it, and feed the poor with it, and intend it as a aqiqah. The Imam al-Sadiq says the aqiqah protects your child from harm. It's as if you're sacrificing that animal on behalf of your child. So this is a sunnah that came into practice after Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam was born. And as Imam al-Hasan grew under the authority and love of Rasulullah, the Holy Prophet used to show him so much love and affection. One day the Prophet was on the minbar. He was giving a khutbah, and he saw Imam al-Hasan. He's young, maybe he is 2-3 years old. He's walking in the masjid, and he's wearing a long dress. Imam al-Hasan, he trips and he falls. The Prophet leaves his sermon. He comes down the pulpit, and he goes and carries his son, Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam. The people in the masjid, the sahaba, they were surprised. Ya Rasulullah, you just left the lecture. You left the sermon, the khutbah, because of a baby? They were surprised when the Holy Prophet did this. But the Holy Prophet wanted to teach them a lesson when he used to show that love and respect for Imam al-Hasan, even though he was a young baby. He wanted to teach them two things. Number one, he wanted to show them to be a little more affectionate and loving with their children. Right now, this is something that we all do. We love our children, we kiss them, we play with them, right? The fathers. Back then, during the Jahiliyyah, this was a taboo upon the men. It was a woman that was a sign of affection. A woman, the mother, would show her children love and affection. The father could not show love and affection because this was seen as a shameful act to show love and affection. It was aib, as we say now. A father had to be cruel. A man in Arabia during the Jahiliyyah had to be cruel. He was ruthless and he could not show any love and affection. And that's why Bukhari narrates this hadith. He says one day that Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam was being carried by Rasulullah. The Prophet kissed him in front of the Sahaba. One of those individuals by the name of Al-Aqra ibn Habis, he was surprised. He told him, Ya Rasulallah, you kiss your grandson? He told him, yes. What's the big deal? He told him, Ya Rasulallah, I have 10 sons. 10 sons I raised. I never kissed any one of them. Never. And he was boasting about that. He was boasting about that. 10 sons and I never kissed any one of them. So you kiss your grandchild? He's not even your son. He's your grandchild? The Prophet was angered. He told him, "Man la yarham la yurham." Whoever does not show mercy, at least to your children, then do not expect Allah Azza wa Jalla's mercy on the Day of Judgment. In a similar hadith, the Prophet said, "What should I do if Allah Azza wa Jalla has stripped your heart of mercy? If there's no mercy in your hearts, let your hearts be merciful. And the least thing you can do is show that mercy to your own children." So number one, the Prophet wanted to teach the people to be more affectionate and loving with children. This is not a shameful act. The Messenger of God does it, so you as well should do it with your children. And number two, the Prophet wanted to show them the status of Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam. That this child is not like all your other children. I'm not just respecting him and carrying him and kissing him because he is my grandchild. It's not because of he's my relative. It's not a matter of emotion. No, Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam is an imam. He's a great personality himself. You see, many times we love our children and we give out so much lavish praise to our children, right? You've seen this, for example, even when you attend a funeral, right? Whoever the deceased was, the children, the family members, they speak about him as if he's an angel. Now, was he really an angel? Only Allah knows. Most of the times, they're just being emotional. My father was an angel. He was this, he was that. Every funeral you attend, this is how they'll speak about their relatives. Why? Because this is, they're being emotional. They love their father, they love their mother, they love their relative, and that's how they're speaking about him. When the Prophet used to praise Imam Hassan and Hussein, he used to call them Raihan Ataya min ad-dunya, for example, or any other praise he used to give them, that wasn't just because a grandfather is praising his grandchildren. No, the Holy Prophet was very accurate with his praises. He used to praise Hassan and Hussein because they were worthy of that praise. Not just because they were his children. Not just because they were his grandchildren. So he wanted to show the Muslims, this grandchild of mine, Hassan, respect him. Just like Rasulullah respected him. Love him. Follow him. And he did the same thing later with Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Unfortunately, all that love and respect they saw from Rasulullah to them, but yet they neglected them and all the oppression that they saw after that. So Imam al-Hasan alayhi salam grew up under the love and under the authority of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. That's why in one hadith, after the Prophet died, maybe Imam Hassan was about 7 years old. The Sahaba, they went to the house of Amir al-Mu'mineen alayhi salam. They had a question from Imam Ali. They said that we saw Imam Hassan, he had a tutor, someone that would come and teach him. They said that we saw Imam Hassan, a young child, and there's this teacher teaching him. When we saw them, you know, in that session, it's as if Imam Hassan was the teacher. He kept on correcting his own teacher. He kept on telling him, you missed this point. You forgot to say this. You made this mistake. So they asked the teacher, are you the teacher or the student? He's making you look bad. And he's a young child because he was raised by Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was raised by the three greatest of Allah's creation. Rasulullah, Imam Ali and Fatima, Allahu Akbar. Can it get any better than that? That you are raised by these three immaculate individuals. So of course he would be so great. One day, Fatima alayhi salam told Imam Ali that every day after Imam Hassan leaves the masjid, he comes home and he tells me what happened during that day. He tells me what, you know, you did, what the Sahaba did, and so on and so forth. He would only tell his mother Fatima, he would never tell Imam Ali because he would be sometimes, the aura of Imam Ali alayhi salam, it would prevent him because he would fear Imam Ali and that respect that he had for his father, that he would not speak in front of him. So Imam Ali told Fatima, I wish I can hear him speak one day. So they made a plan, the hadith says. She told him, tomorrow come back earlier without telling him and hide somewhere in the house. He's going to come and he will begin to tell the stories. He says, good idea. Imam Ali alayhi salam, the next day he comes and he hides somewhere. So Imam Hassan comes, he doesn't know Imam Ali is there. He quickly comes, "My dear mother Fatima, salamu alaykum, alaykum as-salam, tell me my son, what happened today?" Al-Imam al-Hassan wants to speak, but he can't. He stays silent. "My dear son," Fatima tells him, "why don't you speak?" He just stays silent. He doesn't know what's going on. He doesn't know Imam Ali is there. But then he tells his mother Fatima, he tells her these words, "Laqad kalla lisani," my tongue won't speak. I want to speak, but I cannot speak. "Laqad kalla lisani, la'alla sayyidi wa mawlaya yarani." Allahu Akbar. Maybe my father Ali is listening to me and seeing me. That's why my tongue cannot speak. You see the respect that Imam Hassan alayhi salam had for his father? That at the presence of his father, his tongue would not speak. Unfortunately, now our children, you come home, they're on their iPads, laying like couch potatoes. You tell them salam, they don't reply. "Salam." "Oh, alaykum as-salam, you're ruining my game." This is how our kids are now. Imam al-Hassan alayhi salam, he was raised by the greatest of the creation of Allah Azza wa Jal. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to grant us some of these beautiful lessons and some of these beautiful values and virtues that Imam al-Hassan alayhi salam had. And we have to make Al-Imam al-Hassan as a virtue, brothers and sisters. We have to make him as a role model for our children. Those superheroes and these celebrities on YouTube and on the internet aren't their role models. Al-Imam al-Hassan is their role model. Let them grow up loving Al-Imam al-Hassan and let them try to emulate the life of Al-Imam al-Hassan in the best way that they can. هذا وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على محمد وآله الطاهرين.